You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like
video documentary. The documentary is about Margate, one of the best, oldest seaside towns in Britain. In the documentary, Davina is going to take us through the historical significance of Margate and the driven forces of rise and fall of tourism industry in Margate. Then we will look at the Turn Up Contemporary Art Gallery, also the new infrastructure affecting the local businesses and tourism sector from the local coffee shop owner who we interviewed, and he gave us some answers about it, and also from the visitor ambassador who also took the time out to talk about us what he knows about Margate.
Hi everyone, my name is Davina and I'm with me. Today we are filming in Margate. A leading seaside resort for the last 250 years, a traditional holiday destination for people from London to come and enjoy the sandy beaches of Margate. Margate has had a great decline in the last few years with the introduction of holiday packages to places like Spain, Italy, England. Margate has had a decline, but has become to come out. Just like other British coastal towns, like Brighton and Southend, Margate was amongst the many towns infamous for gangs. The gang violences between the mods and the rocks in the 1960s and the mods and the skinheads in the 1980s.
Standing outside of the Turner Contemporary Art Gallery.
and this is all part of a regeneration process to boost the tourism in Margate. It was put up in 2011 at the cost of 17.5 million, and since then there has been a big surge in the tourism coming to Margate. In the first weekend it was open, it attracted 14,000 tourists, and by the first year it attracted 500,000 tourists. And by 2013 it has now attracted over a million tourists, and this is what you see today.
The opening of the Turner Contemporary Museum, it has supported the local community by helping provide a unique learning experience to help people think, see and learn differently, and it's also provided world-class art free of charge to all that come here, and it's definitely been a catalyst in transforming Margate and helping bring tourism back to the area.
Inside there and try and find out what they know about the tourist arrivals and increase or decrease about the tourists since the gallery has been reopened and the Dreamland is going to reopen, and what is their expectation towards that as well.
Information we found from the information center, since the opening of the art gallery, this has a positive impact on economic and tourist arrival in Margate. It was 3.36 million of visitors in 2013, which is 7.3% of increase from 2011, and the total economic impact was £245 million over the years, which is creating more jobs and boosting local businesses. To be exact in figures they provided us, is total numbers of actual jobs was 5,932 jobs was created because of the art galleries being established here and more tourists is coming in here. So as we can clearly see, the art gallery is regenerating the market again.
This is a local coffee shop we went to. He's been there for a long time, and we interviewed the owner of the coffee shop to find out what impact she had since the Turner Contemporary was opened. The coffee shop is right next to the local museum. There's the local museum there. Let's try and find out what the owner of the coffee shop tells us. So this is what we'll find out.
This is what we found out since the opening of the gallery. I'm with the team and show the coffee shop owner. And hard to just say the impact of the opening of the gallery has been on the coffee shop and business within the area.
It is improved, yeah, and we've learned to set up business, the retail shop. Stay down here, or just day trips from London, or local people coming in and spending the day in Margate, where they wouldn't have done maybe the gallery. There's a destination point for them to come, something to see, and then they come and explore around the old town.
That's good. So you would say Margate has improved?
Definitely.
It's improving further?
Yes, yeah, but and we're on the back of the gallery opening, they improved the front, the steps in, the smart people are. So it's ongoing, it's got things to do in Margate, and let's hope when the Dreamland takes off in June that it will fill up the town and everyone enjoy the success of the new generation of artists.
As you can hear, Margate is coming up and there's a larger room for improvement.
We're here with the treasurer of Margate Museum,
right? And Tudor House.
And could you just tell us a little bit about how Margate has revitalized itself as a place?
Well, I've been here for about 40 years, and I came down in, it was going quite well, but gradually, I mean, nationally, all the seaside towns have suffered through the recession and people taking holidays abroad. And through local enthusiasm and volunteers, we've are beginning to, and the Turner Centre, you can't stop. Whether you like it or you don't, it's done it down, a wonderful thing. And we're volunteers at Margate Museum, and there's volunteers all over town, and we want to see Margate. We're very passionate about it. We want to see it come back. In fact, it is on the list of one of the most up-and-coming places in the country. So it's been voted best resort in Europe, apparently, by somebody. And Dreamland will be opening. On June the 19th.
And do you think that will have a big effect on people coming?
Oh, yes, it will, because the more, if you've got people that know, like today, I've just taken some people around, we've got the time ball working on, dropped out, which drops at 1 o'clock every day, like the one at Greenwich, the Maritime Museum. We've got close opening over the way, but it's fine. Well, you haven't been in it, there is a single got the bus.
Yeah.
You haven't seen that,
have you? No, I haven't.
Well, you will in a minute, I'll tell you. So we want to see that they're all passionate about it. And hopefully it's gonna go from good to better.
Yeah. And now he is working as a visitor ambassador here to regenerate the markets. Thanks to him. Thank you. Here we've got another example of a local business that is opening due to the boost of tourism in the Margate area. You can see this one has a full bus in it, which will soon be a cafe for locals in the area. Well, here we can see the reconstruction of Dreamland in Margate. And the roller coaster we can see is one of the oldest roller coaster in England, and they try to rebuild the roller coaster as well to attract more tourists in Margate.
Here is the brief SWOT analysis of Margate. When we look at the strength of Margate, the Margate has full of strength, as in Turner Art Contemporary is their main attraction and their main strength. And they have the beach and sea is the another strength. They also have seaside culture, sky and sunset. The history of the place is the another main strength of Margate. And then they have got the artists like Tracy Emin, who born there, and his childhood is related to Margate, which is another strength for Margate. And then when you look at the weaknesses, the Margate have few weaknesses, as lack of communication to the council, local council. They also have ethnic differences, lack of investment, and the first impression is another weakness for Margate. The people, the tourists, when they think about to go and visit Margate, the first impression is this rundown. Opportunities and threats for markets. Margate have lots of opportunity to improve their economic sector and the tourist sector. They have to improve their art galleries to attract more tourists. They have to improve their visual arts to attract more tourists. They have to attract the Londoners. As we know, the Londoners are, London is a tourist city. The Londoners are attracted to go to visit the attractive places in UK, so they have to attract, their main focus have to be Londoners to bring in their town and improve the tourist sector. And they also have some threats like lack of fundings. They need more fundings to build new infrastructure to attract more tourists. They have to navigate the attractive attraction of tourists from all over the country, all over Europe, to come to Margate. And they have lack of knowledge what Margate have to offer to the tourist. They also have the lack of communication through the tourist sector within the UK.